love the feeling of progression. I love learning new things. That's what excites me about riding a bike.
Man, what a sport. What a sport. Yeah, wow. So scary, but that's why it's so good, right? Just love it.
Do you know, I had that mentality where it was like, I'll do what it takes.
That was savage.
If I can't turn pro off the back of this, then I'll never do it. Ready?
Yeah.
Interview one. And we're back. Been busy. A lot of groundwork going on. Going back racing. But this year looks like I'm gonna have the backing to become a full-time professional bike rider.
Do you think I'll be alright?
You look good at least.
Key focus is mountain bike racing. To have competed at the Marathon World Championships last year, that's another goal for this year.
I've always said I'm a late bloomer, right? The ripe old age of 36, I might have finally cracked it. That's the big change. I can't believe it.
So I was in Spain training on my own. While I was there, the opportunity to train with the call Wahoo came up. That was cool.
Our friend Meeks was really jealous that we were riding with him, so looking forward to living up to the hype.
Comes with a legendary status. Perhaps it's an age thing.
I follow him on Instagram.
Yeah.
The main thing I'm feeling is I feel nervous. I'm the outsider. You know, they're here on business. I don't want to cause a crash or something like that.
This is what my life's like every day. It's always just cars out, just like, yeah, this is so normal for me.
How was that?
Hard.
Savage, right? Made me wish that I was part of that team all the time, though, because the support was fantastic.
Living the dream. Living the dream.
I mean, in the past, I've done loads of training camps, but the issue I had, my lifestyle when I was at home wasn't good enough. I would go on a camp for 10 days, I would overtrain for 10 days, I would come home and I would undertrain. After the World Champs, I had usual post-race blues, like feeling a bit aimless, not really knowing what I was doing. I still rode, but just going through the motions, if you like. Previously, I used to train for races, whereas now I train because I want to. I can't imagine that I would stop this routine that I've got. Maybe I wouldn't put as much time into it, but I would want to ride every day. Just always be working towards something. What people maybe don't realise about securing sponsors or signing contracts is there's a lot of groundwork. It's a case of going to the brands, going to the sponsors that you work with an idea and asking them to help.
The way I would describe it is it's like you spend days, weeks and even months working on something and you don't really feel like you get anywhere with it, and then in the space of a week or even a day or a phone call, it's like you end up jumping forward. It's like you're always just chipping away, chipping away, chipping away. Feels maybe like you're banging your head against the wall, and then sometimes just things come together.
I guess the beauty of writing your own training is you can adapt it a bit. If it's real bad weather, I might do something alternative, or I'll have a look at what the forecast looks like. But I mean, ultimately, it's a choice. Having access to the riding we have in Scotland, it's just, it is honestly everywhere. Every town or village seems to have its own riding community and its own trails. Aberfoyle, super close to Glasgow. The mountain biking there is awesome. Short drive out, feels like you're miles away.
We used to go to Spain.
If you ride some of the steep technical stuff at places like Aberfoyle, you're never going to see anything like that in a cross-country race. Slippy, sketchy, janky trails. The scene, I guess, in Scotland is is solid. The British Cross Country Mountain Bike Series has been the backbone of my competition calendar for, you know, every year that I've competed, really. It's so important that we have a national series. It deserves to be shouted about. The way that the sport has developed in the UK over the last 20 years is fantastic. To say that the men's Olympic champion is British and the women's world champion is British, you just wouldn't have believed that.
I think a lot has, in terms of how we have a performance-based programme, has come across from, particularly from the track, really. But the other thing that's just came across is the number of talented young bike riders that have then had opportunities to stay within the sport. Yeah, pinning numbers on, whether it's on a BMX, a mountain bike, a local like little road crit, it's all perfect. We've got kids coming through now that just want to be pro bike riders and recognise that this is as valid a route as anything else, really, which is good. And there's nothing better than surviving in and around a track like this to learn how to bike race.
Practice, it starts with just a really steady ride just to get a feel for the course. Gradually just kind of try and introduce a bit of speed. Check out the A lines and the B lines, because sometimes A lines get closed and you don't want it the first time that you're riding a line to be in the race.
The field was pretty stacked. A lot of really good young riders.
Charlie Aldridge, 2019 Junior World Champion. Cameron Mason, under 23 Cyclocross World Cup winner. Lewis Askey, World Tour Pro.
It's so nerve-wracking waiting. You don't know what's going to happen. I've trained hard. I feel good. It's about the process and the journey. Didn't go to plan. I didn't get my pedal. Tried to stay calm and just not panic too much. When we dropped down into the gully, heart rate through the flipping roof, like up in the 180s. I didn't have a good idea of exactly where I was in the field overall. It was really more a case of just trying to just settle in and just ride my own race. I found myself by like laps 2 and 3 was in quite a big group. Everyone in that group was good, like they were fast and they were strong. There wasn't really much between us. Instead of thinking about reeling riders in who might have been in front, the objective was to try and be the first finisher out of that group. Whittled down to, I think there was only maybe 3 or 4 of us left. Time to commit and go full gas. Went to the front and put the pressure on. Really, really just went all in and went as hard as I could.
Apart from the start, it couldn't have gone any better. I feel like that went mint.
Look at that. Oh my God. Zone 1 or zone 6. Full gas. Finished 11th, same as my number board. I was really hoping to be in the top 10 and score some points, but I can't complain too much.
Average 166 beats for an hour 20.
Happy because I beat the guys that I was with, so that was really was the objective. Yeah, I'm keen for more. You know, next weekend in Newcastleton, and then I'm off to Portugal for some work and ride a UCI race out there, so before getting back into a training block. So I'm happy. Happy.
So he's doing 2 and 1.
Lost the front end.
That makes sense, do both the first time.
Set myself a bit of a challenge at the Enduro World Series. four big days, back to back, two races, be my first ever e-bike race. I'm very excited about. I expect to be a fish out of water.
Oh, fuck!
It's an opportunity to ride against the world's best in Scotland. Ah, cheating, innit? E-biking.
From 36 to 11. Take that, we'll see how far up we can get this year. For pink bike commenters, we've noticed we've trimmed the brake hose as well, so I know that offended a few people, but it's fixed. Still haven't weighed it, sorry.